Do you know there are 10,000 genetic disorders caused by mutation or change in single genes? Individually, these disorders are rare, but as a whole, they affect about 1% of the total population. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Imran Wahid. Welcome to my channel, Anatomy with Imran. Today, we will talk about single gene disorders. By watching this video, you will be able to understand different types of single gene disorders, genetic mechanism of inheritance of these disorders, and at the end you will be able to identify the type of disorder by looking at the pedigree. There are different types of genetic disorders, for example, disorders due to single gene inheritance, due to defect in the multiple genes and enhanced by environmental factors, chromosomal abnormality, structural or numerical abnormality of chromosome, and mutation or defect in the mitochondrial DNA. So genetic disorders actually consists of all these things. But today we will be discussing only about single gene disorders. Let's first understand what is single gene disorder. You can see a chromosomal picture of a somatic cell. There are 22 pairs of autosome and one pair of sex chromosome. The sex chromosome can either be XX or XY. Now let's focus on a single chromosome. For example, if we focus on chromosome 7, we can see that there are 900 to 1000 of genes in this particular chromosome. We know that some genes are dominant and some are recessive by character. The arrow indicates a gene known as CFTR. It is a recessive gene. Mutation in this gene is responsible for a clinical disorder known as cystic fibrosis. I think now you can understand what is meant by single gene disorder. Again, single gene disorder also comprises a certain spectrum of disorder. We have autosome and sex chromosome. Again, we have genes of dominant character and of recessive character. Considering this, single gene disorders can be classified into these four categories: autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked dominant and X-linked recessive. We will discuss one by one. At first, we will understand the mechanism of inheritance. Then we will see some examples. Please look at the picture. The arrow indicates the mutation of a dominant gene. The sons and the daughters who will inherit a single copy of that mutated gene will be affected. Since the copy is dominant, it will express. In this pattern of inheritance, both males and females are equally affected. Usually, 50% of the offsprings have probability of being affected. Again, both parents may be normal and the offspring can get a new mutation. So this is another way of having autosomal dominant disorder. Now we will see some examples. Huntington's disease is a neurodegenerative disorder, mostly affecting the basal ganglia. Marfan syndrome is a connective tissue disorder. Usually, the patient has a large stature and long arms and fingers. Now, let's come to our next category. In this picture, you can see both parents have got the mutation. But in this case, the gene is recessive by character. So, the parents themselves are healthy. Now, what is the probability of their offsprings of being affected? The offspring who will inherit the both copy of the mutated gene will only have the disorder. Usually 25% offspring are affected. Now the offspring who have inherited a single copy will be carriers. The carriers will have no symptom, they will be healthy, but they will pass the defected or mutated gene to his or her next generation. Cystic fibrosis is a good example of such autosomal recessive disorder. Here, the mucus becomes thick and sticky, obstructing the airway. Another example is sickle cell anemia. In this case, sickle-shaped RBC are produced and they have less capacity of carrying oxygen. Please note, consanguineous marriage leads to such disorder in the next generation. Now come to our next category, X-linked dominant inheritance. In this picture, you can see father has got the mutation in the dominant gene of X chromosome. Now, what is the probability of being affected among his offsprings? Here, we need to consider two things. Number one, dominant gene will always express. Another is, sons do not receive X chromosome from father. Only daughter receives X chromosome from father. So, sons will not be affected and all the daughters will be affected. Now, let's consider another scenario. Here, mother has got the mutation. Now, what will happen? Sons and daughters both receive X chromosome from mother. So, sons and daughters who will inherit the mutated gene will be affected. An example of X-linked dominant disorder is Fragile X syndrome. The child with this disorder usually has developmental delay and learning disability. Now, let's discuss our last category, X-linked recessive inheritance. It is very obvious that the mutation will be in the X chromosome and the gene will be recessive, isn't it? If father has the mutation, what will happen to the offspring? We already know that sons do not receive any X chromosome from father, so they will be healthy. Again, daughters inherit two copies of X chromosome, one from father and one from mother. So, the daughters inheriting defective gene from the father will be carrier. What if the mother carries the mutated gene? Here, we need to consider two things. Son only has one X chromosome, which he receives from his mother. So, the son will be affected. And since the daughter has two copies of X chromosome, if she receives the mutated copy from her mother, she will be carrier. So, here son is the affected person and daughter is the carrier. Duchenne muscular dystrophy is an example of X-linked recessive disorder. Here the patient has progressive muscular weakness. Another example is color blindness. Here the patient usually cannot differentiate between red and green. Now, let's find out the disorder from the pedigree analysis. Let's introduce ourselves with some of the signs that will be required to analyze the pedigree. The left one having the plus sign is the female and the right one is the male. Female is also indicated by circle and male by square. Now, central dot or central coloration indicates the unaffected carrier and the total change of color indicates that the person is affected. So, unaffected no color change and affected change of color. Please observe the pedigree first and then you have to identify the type of disorder. At first, you have to consider, is it dominant disorder or recessive disorder? Dominant gene will always express. Here we can see that there are some carrier state, so it is not dominant. It is a recessive disorder. Again, is it autosomal or sex-linked disorder? In autosomal disorder, male and female are equally affected. We can see that here, from the parents, female is affected and from the grandchildren, male is affected. Again, in X-linked recessive disorder, females are the carrier, male are not the carrier. In this pedigree, we can see a male as carrier. So, it is definitely pedigree of autosomal recessive disorder. Let's look at our second pedigree. Let's first consider, is it a dominant disorder or recessive disorder? We can observe in all generations, there are affected individuals and there is no carrier state. So, it is indicating a dominant disorder. Again, male and female both are affected in different generations. So, there is no such incidence that only daughters are affected from father or only sons are affected from mother. Therefore, we can say that it is a pedigree of autosomal dominant disorder. Now, look at our third pedigree. Is it dominant or recessive? You can see there are carrier state and in all generations, individuals are not affected. Due to skip of generation, we can say that it is a recessive disorder. Please notice, females are the carriers and the males are the affected. Okay, let's consider from the first generation. From the father, by inheriting the defective gene, the daughter has become the carrier. And then she has passed her defective gene to her son. And in the third generation, her son has become affected. So it is definitely X-linked recessive disorder. This one is for you. Please try to identify the type of disorder and let me know in the comment section. I think you have got a general idea about the types of single gene disorders and how to identify from the pedigree analysis. You can also make Punnett square and identify the percentage of the affected individuals. But I have shown you a simplest approach. If you like the video, share it with your friends. and please subscribe this channel to stay in touch.